The top people will not be held responsible. Mr. Brooks isn't the only one who turns a blind eye at practices that make others gag. There are a lot of shit kickers in America who approve of hanging Mohammedans up by the testicles until they die. I suspect, though, there are more of us who do not approve or would not approve if we noticed, but we are busy speculating in real estate, watching the basketball playoffs, bitching about the price of gasoline, or planning summer vacations. We do not pay attention to what is done in our name. And it's quite a name we're getting. The world's number one and only superpower, the Johnny Appleseed of democracy. Quite a name. But I also feel the vacuum, the loneliness, the silence, the dehydration of the soul as people who want desperately to save our Constitution, country, and planet still wander the streets without even knowing how to say hi to one another. From outright lies about WMDs to having political operatives doctor scientific reports to paying so-called journalists for distorting our news to now ballooning its meager record on terrorism convictions, the Bushites will go down in history as the gang that couldn't speak straight. My income is $1,200, but the fact that someone is standing up to what is being done to this country has to be supported. I have disliked and mistrusted presidents before, but never have I feared one. This man is dangerous and will destroy us. Lethal fanatics rule America. They have no principles, no scruples, no regrets, no shame. Nixon gave us his plumbers, thugs, and creeps. His contempt for fair play and the rule of law, the Reagan-Bush regime attracted right-wing screwballs and foreign policy vigilantes. With George W. Bush, got all the worst of both and many of the same faces.